I'm about to launch from the shadows like a lion on the grind coming at you. I'm a menace for the vengeance, so relentless. Hope you ready, cause I'm here to battle. Keeping me awake till the late night. Thinking about a wrong, I'ma make right. When you see me, better take flight. Venom in my veins, and I'm all out of play nice. And it's bye-bye gone to the bygones. Ain't no turning back when the fight's on. When you see the white in my eyes, better run, better hide. No surviving what I'm on.
I ain't here to play around. If I were you, I would run right now. Make your feet bang, bang on the ground. Cause I'ma hunt you down, down, down. I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down, down, down. Yeah. Cause I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down.
Up, guys, Dashing here, bringing you episode 30 of Octane, and we are jumping straight into the action as always as things get started here tonight with the debut of a brand new superstar there on the right, Ben Stacy, the protege of, as you can see, Jay Young. Jay Young has been training this young man over the last few months and has decided it's finally time for him to get his feet wet, and he is certainly gonna do so. He ain't just getting his feet wet, he's jumping straight into the deep end as his very first match is gonna be against none other than the returning Andrew Briggs. We have not seen Briggs, guys, in quite a while. He's been MIA, but, well, like I was talking about last night during Shockwave with the Royal Rumble match making its return in less than 2 weeks at Mob Violence, everyone is coming out of the woodwork. We had a couple of debuts last night, some returns, everyone, man and woman alike, they want to be a part of the Royal Rumble match at Mob Violence, and Andrew Briggs is no exception. The benchmark making his return to action here tonight, and I'm sure putting over some young talent not on the agenda. You could sort of look at Ben Stacy like a second or even really a third generation product, trained by Jay Young, and Jay Young was trained by Hall of Famer, the technical prodigy Dave Turner. So Ben Stacy, coming from a long line, quite a lineage to live up to. We'll see if he can and get his CMV career started with a bang by knocking off someone the caliber of Andrew Briggs. Hell of a show we've got in store, my friends. The Rite of Passage Championship on the line a little bit later on as Ethan Parker finally gonna get his shot, taking on the new champion, Ozone. And in our main event, the new Unified World Tag Team Champions, the SNS Connection of the company, taking on the team of the returning Ted and Joseph Santos ahead of Mob Violence, guys, where we know the agent will be defending his global championship against both the Ted and Joseph Santos in a triple threat match. And the two of them work together here tonight, though, to pick up some momentum and get a win over the company. Big time elbow drop from Andrew Briggs as you see Jay Young shouting from ringside, commanding Ben Stacy. Not looking good so far, though, for the rookie. Stiff kick to the lower back and another jumping elbow drop. Andrew Briggs has done nearly everything there is to do, guys, here in CMV, but he has never won a Royal Rumble match. Perhaps this will be his year. Yet another accolade to add to the already stacked Hall of Fame worthy resume. Sidewinder suplex. Beautifully executed by Stacy. Follows it up with a knee drop to the extended arm. And now gonna go for the head with an elbow. Dragon screw from Briggs. Able to catch that kick. Lightning fast reflexes of Andrew Briggs. Kick to the midsection. But Ben Stacy gonna fire back by tripping up Briggs. Double boot stomp to the chest. And Jay Young, guys, playing around at ringside. Looks like he wants to give his protege a bit of a helping hand. Throws in a steel chair as Andrew Briggs with the back rotation suplex to the corner. Not looking to give Stacy a chance to use that chair. Vintage Briggs here with the running knee to the side of the head. Stacy sees it coming and clotheslines Andrew right out of the ring. Hey, that would have eliminated him from the Royal Rumble. That's what's going to happen to Bret. Can't wait to see a brainbuster at ringside. Sickening impact and now going to break the eyes again. Seems like these fans are not on the side of the young Ben Stacy. They are excited to see Andrew Briggs back in action. Hatch suplex. Stacy gonna get back into the ring after helping Andrew Briggs to his feet. And look at that. Young and brash. Perhaps not taking Andrew Briggs seriously here. Gonna cut him off as he's getting back into the ring. Johnson finding the steel chair, gets rid of it. In the corner, Briggs gonna escape, spinning back fist, catching Stacy off guard. Now gonna give him the old snake eyes. Doesn't stop there though, grabbing the arm, slamming it down onto the mat. Wheelbarrow attempt by Ben Stacy, thwarted by Briggs. Hurricanrana! And the rolling neck snap seems to be keeping the pressure on the head and neck of Ben Stacy in this match. To the top rope. Are we gonna see that corkscrew? Senton, yes we are. Vintage Andrew Briggs. Ahoo! Ahoo! So impactful, it must have knocked some dust into the air. Made me sneeze, excuse me. But unfortunately, Briggs not able to keep Ben Stacy down for the count there. As Ben from the corner with an Okada roll, German suplex, and a bridge. One, two. What form from Ben Stacy. Didn't get him the win, but stays on the attack, going after the arm of Andrew Briggs. Zeroing in on that left arm specifically. As Jay Young likes what he's seeing right now. Probably didn't like that very much. Forearm smash, Kip-up immediately comes back with a dragon screw. And now Ben Stacy, what is he looking for here? Oh, a Samoan driver. One, two. Ben Stacy does not look very Samoan to me, but he did pull that off without a hitch and almost had Andrew Briggs down for the count. Kick to the back, just trying to maintain the upper hand, but Briggs able to roll out of the way of that elbow drop. Another Hurricanrana. Adding another rolling neck snap. Jay Young from ringside. Not saying a single thing right now as Andrew Briggs unloads a barrage of elbow drops. Impressed with the performance of Ben Stacy thus far, not only holding his own against Andrew Briggs here, almost had him beat a couple of minutes ago too, but right now Andrew Briggs certainly in the driver's seat, having his way with the rookie. Gives him the snake eyes again. Tries for a stop though, and Stacy gonna catch him with a kick to the midsection. Knife edge chop misses. Leaves him wide open. Briggs gonna send him into the corner. Numerous kicks to the midsection, and now some knees just popping off. Andrew Briggs has no time for the youngins. Stomp to the midsection, kick to the chest. I know I already said that my favorite for the men's Royal Rumble match is gonna be Brandon Ace, but honestly, Jay Young has my eye as well. With 30 men entering the Royal Rumble match, it's hard to pick. From the full mount position, Ben Stacy, perhaps looking to keep Andrew Briggs down for good as he sends him into the corner. Up on the top, Ben Stacy. Wow, what athleticism from the rook. That jumping hurricanrana, and now he's got the arm. Not just the arm though, the armbar leg lock combo here. Middle of the ring, Andrew Briggs in trouble, and Briggs taps! Briggs taps, wow! Talk about a debut! Ben Stacy putting himself on the map right away. Not only defeating the returning Andrew Briggs here tonight, but tapping him out in the middle of the ring, Jay Young has got to be proud. Great action to kick off Octane episode 30. Like I said, coming from a long line of technical wrestlers, Ben Stacy, dare I say, might have a bright future here in CMV after a win like that straight out the gate. Coming up next, our second matchup of the evening, guys. A sort of rematch from last episode of Octane. You might remember we were supposed to see Nina one-on-one with Maggie Shaw. But this woman right here, Isabella Almas, ended up attacking Maggie Shaw backstage, dragged her out here and threw her down, and then took her place in the match and ended up knocking off Nina, who obviously was caught off guard. Nina not going to be fooled again here tonight. She's been preparing for this matchup all week long. And we'll see if Isabella Almas can get the win again when she doesn't have that advantage. Almas did go on live earlier this week, or more appropriately, hijacked Amare's Instagram live session and said the reason that she did what she did was a couple weeks ago in that tag team match, Mina embarrassed her by tying her up in that Windsor knot and then kicking her you-know-where. And Alma's saying she is not the one to be treated like that. Isabella Alma said, I'm that bitch, and you don't disrespect me like that without getting what for. But Mina, irritated, I'm sure, after what happened last episode of Octane, and probably even more irritated about what happened to her friend, Maggie Shaw. You know, Mina and Maggie Shaw go way back. They were looking forward to having a good match with one another, and Isabella almost ruined that. And a tweet, guys, from Joy Justice says, come on, Almas, end this quickly. We need to get to training for the women's tag team titles. Yes, indeed. Joy Justice and Isabella almost making it clear they want a shot at the women's tag team championship. But first, Almas with a bit of business to take care of here. And, well, Almas, guys, trying to fool Mina at the start of this match with a faux handshake. Mina was not about to fall for it, so Almas just takes the cheap shot anyhow. If Mina was coming into this matchup pissed off, man, even more so now. The cheek of Almas, never more on display than just now. But at the same time, guys, you know these two women both looking to be a part of the Women's Royal Rumble match in less than 2 weeks at Mob Violence. 30 women, the first time ever, 30 women will partake in the Royal Rumble match for a shot at the Women's World Championship come validation. Almost looking to knock off Mina early. No such luck, though. Follows it up with a rolling neck snap. And now to the top rope. Johnson telling her to get the hell down. Wait a minute. Almost. Oh, I thought she was looking for the imploding Phoenix Splash already, but misses instead that corkscrew moonsault. Mina now to the top rope with a Hurricane Rana. Rapid kicks to the face to think this started. Simply because Mina utilized the maneuver she's been utilizing for quite some time, the Windsor knot. Isabella almost maybe taking it a little too personally. Knees to the face to escape that attempted reverse DDT. Oh no, and look at this! Mina has got almost tied up in the Windsor knot again, and a kick to the bum. Oh, almost gonna be fuming. She dared Mina to try that again, and Mina just did that. Lifting reverse DDT. Vintage Minaplex. Almost in a world of trouble right now. Hooks the leg, 1, 2. Almost having the match won there, not quite enough. Mina arguing with Johnson, but goes back on the attacker, tries to do so with some knees to the midsection. Instead, kicks being fired off by Alma, sending Mina into the corner. Slow approach here as she lines up her shot. Drop kick into the corner, and the back of Mina's head smacking right off that middle turnbuckle. The positioning couldn't be more perfect here. Gotta be looking for that imploding Phoenix Splash, but Mina to her feet still gets caught with that corkscrew arm drag. And now from the corner, almost tuning up the bed, and we know what comes next. Sweet chin music. 1, 2. But Mina got that jaw of steel. Almost right back on the attack as she grabs the arm of Mina, maybe looking for that that torture rack that she and Amari Rivers like to use, but Mina instead takes her down. Another lifting reverse DDT to the top rope. Talk about perfect positioning. Mina gonna wait for almost to get to her feet. Diving drop kick. Followed up by the dreaded foot DDT. And the Meniora. One, two. I thought that would have sealed the deal right there. So did Mina, but she wastes no time. Another Meniora. One, two, three. You don't play with the girl, Mina. And Isabella almost just learned that the hard way. The Meniora not once, but twice in a row to put Isabella Almas down for the Uno, the Dosen, yes, the Tres. A great win for young Mina here tonight. Isabella Almas may have gotten lucky last episode of Octane, but Mina was ready for her and her antics here tonight. And coming up next, my friends, a matchup that I have been looking forward to all week long as the new and improved Ellie Quinn prepares to go one-on-one with Kate Strongheart. We saw that amazing matchup just last night on Shockwave between Ashley Rain and Kyo. In the end, Rain picking up the win en route to Mob Violence, guys, where we now know she will be defending her Women's World Championship against Ashley Riot, the Battle of the Ashleys, defeating Chloe Marks in that number one contenders match. Yeah, and of course, Ellie Quinn fresh off of the match of the night. She and Keo just battering each other from pillar to post. Keo getting the dub when all was said and done, guys. But afterwards, Ellie Quinn saying directly to the camera as if she was staring into the soul of Keo, "This is far from over. This ends between you and I when I say it ends. Don't go thinking that you're going to just get that win and ride off into the sunset." And Ellie Quinn keeping her word last night when she interfered in that match between Rain and Keo. But going into the Royal Rumble match, guys, at Mob Violence, both of these women right here have got to be favorites. Both former women's world champions. This might be, honestly, the toughest year that I can recall picking a winner. For both Rumbles, too. Not just the men, but the women as well. Brandon Ace, Jay Young, but I'm just thinking about everyone else on the roster. And then when it comes to the women, we saw Yvonne Ivy pick up the win in that over-the-top rope battle royal last night in Aftershock. She looked great. I thought maybe she could be a dark horse, but man, I just don't know. I think it's truly anyone's game come Mob Violence. But again, undeniably, these two have to be favorites. As we get things started, Zach Cage, of course, at ringside in the corner of his client, Ellie Quinn. We have not heard from either Quinn or Cage yet regarding the offer from the company to join the hostile takeover of Jackson Wright. But Shay Hoxton saying that he likes what he's been seeing from the duo and would love to work with them if they make the right move. Urging them to pick the right. The line has been drawn in the sand after attack on Australia, guys. The last night on Shockwave, we saw a lot of people, a lot of superstars pick their side. We saw, of course, Hunter Quinn align with Jackson Wright. Brandon Ace, meanwhile, shocking a lot of people when he shook the hand of Dante Tatum. Ellie Quinn sent to ringside. Kate Stronghart, though, gonna stay on top of her. From side control, closed fists. Trying to maybe even break the nose of Kate Stronghart here. Ooh, damn, throws her right into the announce table. Still to come tonight, guys, the Rite of Passage Championship on the line as the new champion, Ozone, winner of the ladder match at Attack on Australia, makes his first defense against Ethan Parker. Now that has the potential to be a barn burner. We've also got our main event tag team matchup, the new Unified World Tag Team Champions, the SNS Connection, Slayton Hawks, taking on the team of Ted and Joseph Santos. That'll be a fragile alliance between those two going into Mob Violence, where of course the agent will defend his global championship against both Ted and Santos in a triple threat match up to a count of 10 year. Ellie Quinn gonna throw Stronghart gut first into the barricade and now back into the ring gonna mock kick Stronghart. 12. These two have a long, long history with one another, but the last time they faced off one-on-one, they were both very different people, I would say. Especially Ellie Quinn, but Kate Stronghart's gone through her own metamorphosis over the last couple of months and her, of course, dealings with her former tag team partner, Ashley Rain. Rain stabbing her in the back, at regicide, aligning the chain reaction, and then an attack on Australia. The two having a great no holds barred match with the Women's World Championship on the line, but the dust settled. Reign still the Women's World Champion. Now Strongheart gonna work her way back up to the top, get another shot. Winning the Royal Rumble is a good way to do that. Misses the CTE as Ellie Quinn able to roll out of the way. Stomping on the shoulder. And now going to fixate on that right arm to the top rope though, guys. Look at that positioning. 450 splash, but the knees get put up. Quick thinking from Strongheart even makes Zach Cage cringe as he watches that ringside. And now Kate, no time to waste, into the sharpshooter. A maneuver Ellie Quinn knows all too well. This sharpshooter has tapped her out multiple times. But will it hit tonight? No, it will not. The Ellie Quinn of old may have tapped out there, but the new and improved Ellie Quinn survives. Escapes that back suplex attempt. Ooh, grabs Kate by the ponytail and a stomp to the bicep. Kick to the midsection, caught though by Kate. Single leg takedown, bulldogging her way. Back to the top rope, might be looking to try the CTE again. Yes, she is! Oh, but again, Ellie Quinn gets out of the way. Not even waiting for Strongheart to get up. Kick to the chest. And another stomp to the arm. To the top rope, Ellie Quinn gonna try the 450 splash again. Yes, she is, and this time it hits. One, two. Both women firing off their biggest and best shot. Strongheart with the sharpshooter, Ellie Quinn with the 450. Neither getting the job done, but Strongheart already back to her feet and immediately to work on the legs of Ellie Quinn. Puts a stop to that. Snap in the arm of Kate Strongheart. Quinn just really all over Strongheart here tonight. Tells the crowd to hush as she hits that swinging neckbreaker. One, two, and golly damn, almost had the match won right there. 2.999, doesn't seem to be finished though. Kick to the midsection, and again. Strongheart taking her for a walk into the corner. Gives her a taste of that top turnbuckle. Kick to the face. Gonna tie her up in the ropes here. Kate Strongheart saying, what up to Zach Cage? Drop kick to the face. Innovative offense from Kate Strongheart. Gets clipped with that cross body. Tries to get right back up. Ellie Quinn gonna help her, but looking for that impaler DDT, countered by Strongheart at the very last second. And Kate circling her guys like a great white shark in the deep blue sea, smells blood. The sharpshooter locked in again. Nowhere to go for Ellie Quinn. Will she be forced to tap? You can see Zach Cage frantic at ringside. But again, Ellie Quinn refused to give up, but this time she didn't escape. Guys, I think she's passed out from the pain. No! Back to life just in time. And Strongheart can't believe it. Double axe handle. Off the ropes, jumping clothesline. Kate Strongheart got that energy coursing through her veins right now. Elbow to the side of the head from Ellie. Forearm smash, and again. Able to catch that last one, throws out a hook to the jaw, kick to the midsection, forearm smash, blocked, back and forth here between these two. Snap vertical suplex, countered midair, drops down behind as Ellie Quinn. German suplex! Ellie Quinn slowly making her way to the top rope as she looks for a second 450 splash! One, two, doing what she probably wouldn't have been able to do a couple of months ago, and that's beat Kate Strongheart. Surviving the sharpshooter not once but twice to come back and win this match here tonight. Ellie Quinn is most certainly ready for the Royal Rumble match. Not just the new Ellie Quinn, not just the improved Ellie Quinn, the best Ellie Quinn. And coming up next, guys, a highly anticipated matchup, at least for me personally, as Ethan Parker finally gets a shot at the Rite of Passage Championship, the shot he was supposed to get last month, was supposed to challenge the Ted while he was Rite of Passage Champion, but you'll recall Jay Young ambushed Ethan Parker before the match started, and the championship match ended up getting tossed out. The Ted wasn't too upset about that. But gonna, at long last, receive his opportunity here tonight. Challenging the brand new Rite of Passage champion, Ozone, the winner of that hectic ladder match at Attack on Australia. Ozone making his return to CMV a few weeks ago, guys, and he has been red hot since. Unbeaten. 2 long years he was away from CMV, but it's like he hasn't missed a day. But we are looking at the voted next big thing. The CMV Universe seeing a bright future for Ethan Parker here in CMV. But lately, guys, things have not been going so well for Parker. A couple of losses to Jay Young, and he's coming into this matchup with not a whole lot of momentum on his side. Will this be a turning point for the next big thing? Or will Ozone keep the train running? The man himself, and I gotta say, that championship looking gorgeous around his waist. And of course, as the Rite of Passage champion, guys, he can cash that championship in for a shot at either the Global Championship or the Undisputed World Heavyweight Championship. But the longer he takes to decide to cash it in, the more he must defend it. And so making his first defense here tonight That's what it's all about. The Rite of Passage Championship. Ethan Parker been waiting a very long month, I'm sure, to get this opportunity here tonight and not looking to let it pass him by without giving it socks. Ozone has always been an enigma throughout his days in CMV. Not a lot is really known about this man under the mask. But all that really needs to be known is that he is undefeated since his return to CMV. Will Ethan Parker hand him his first loss here tonight? The next big thing, Ozone. Rite of Passage Championship, let's get it on, baby. Still to come tonight, my friends. We have got Czar in action. You talk about favorites going into the Royal Rumble match. He's gotta be up there, Ozone. Vintage match starter, the springboard cutter. Straight out the gate, having Parker feeling some type of way. We've also got some mixed tag team action coming up a little bit later on as Marvelous Marvin and Melandra Munoz gonna take on the team of Gavin Epsilon and Jade Divine. Ozone to the top rope. No time to waste for the Rite of Passage champion, Hanukkah Narada. Guys, I think he caught Ethan Parker off guard. Parker was not ready for the man known as Ozone. Into the corner now, Ethan Parker finally with a chance to throw out a bit of offense, but Ozone shuts that shit down with the quickness, misses the wheelbarrow though, and Parker gonna deliver a kick to the midsection, forearm smash, hook to the jaw, and again, tries for a jumping knee, but Ozone able to sidestep him and a boot right to the side of the head, but not once that stayed out very long. Snap vertical suplex. Two very, very different styles here. We are already seeing that. Clear as day. Ethan Parker, a mat wrestler, great technician. And I think a lot of people sleep on his power. Meanwhile, Ozone, death-defying man, loves to take to the air as he already has multiple times in this match. It's only been going on a couple of minutes. Oh, look at that, Ozone firing back with a dragon screw. And now an Irish whip sending Parker into the corner. Slow approach, maybe a bit too slow. Ethan waiting for him with an elbow. Irish whip sending the champion out onto the apron. Right hook to the jaw, but a forearm smash gonna get Ozone back into the ring. Springboard Hurricane Rana. Hit to the chest, keeping Parker down. Straight back up though. Back in Ozone into the corner. Taste that top turnbuckle, boy. You can see Ethan Parker with a tornado DDT. Has Ozone down in the middle of the ring to the top rope. Ethan Parker gonna throw caution to the wind here as he waits for Ozone to get to his feet. A little bit of a distance. Double axe handle though, it pays off. Kicking it old school and follows that up, maybe looking for the trifecta, but Ozone was ready for it. Irish whip into the corner. Elbow again. Parker able to escape whatever Ozone was cooking up there. And it's Ozone instead put into the corner. But he escapes with an elbow to the jaw. Snap! Dragon suplex, dropping Parker on his head. But man, talk about fast paced. Since that bell rang, these two have just been firing off a million miles a minute. No chance for Reprieve. Ethan Parker with the bow and arrow, digging his knees into the lower back of Ozone. Gets out of it with that tadpole splash. Both men to their feet, collar double tie up, knee to the jaw, inverted Frankensteiner. Parker gets right back up. Ozone with a springboard Pele kick to the top rope, looking for the lowdown. Yes, sir! Hooks the leg. 1, 2, no! Ozone a bit pissed off, getting in Johnson's face there. Ethan Parker, though, with a second chance, and he's not going to let it slip through his fingers. Irish whip into the corner. Not sure what the hell is going on here, but it turns into another inverted Frankensteiner. Ethan Parker on his feet. Forearm smash. Puts Ozone down, kick to the face. Keeps him there for now. Yeah, I don't think Ethan Parker was fully prepared, man, for Ozone here tonight. Jumping elbow drop, but he's trying to do his best to keep his head above the water. Into the corner, cautious approach by Parker. Puts Ozone up at the top rope, and hang on a minute! Looking for that running power slam! Holy shit, hooks the leg! 1, 2, 3, wow! Ethan Parker! Just like that, baby, all it takes is one! And we have a new Rite of Passage champion! Can you believe it? Ozone back to his feet, handed his first loss since returning, but he's got respect for the next big thing in the new Rite of Passage champion. What a match, man. We got to run that back. But we have got a new Rite of Passage champion, and his name is Ethan Parker, baby. And guys, when you think of the Royal Rumble match, you think of superstars like Czar. You think of superstars like Morgan, like the Ozakai, who have declared themselves for the Royal Rumble match at Mob Violence. And you think, how in the hell is someone gonna get Czar over the top rope? We have seen him in action, guys, over the past month or so on Ignition. Very, very impressed with this Hulk. And looking to showcase himself to a broader audience here tonight en route to Mob Violence. Taking on a fellow newcomer in Aquile, guy who we actually saw debut last night on Aftershock with a loss to Richard Gelaney, and I don't know that he's gonna fare much better against Czar. But the kid is certainly gonna take his shot. I guess you gotta respect him for even having the balls to get into that ring tonight. So here we go, Czar Aquile, one on one. And Aquile, oh, Czar with a tombstone pile driver. I was just about to say, Aquile actually just about as tall as Czar. Not a small guy, but like I said, Czar with a chance here tonight to show off exactly what he brings to the table to the CM Universe, who maybe haven't been tuning into his Ignition matches over the past month and change. And he is, gonna do just that. Manhandling Aquile here, dropping him out of the military press again. Knee to the face, but tripped up. Collar elbow time, Irish whip. Gonna send him into the corner. Czar putting him up on the top rope just to punch him. A couple of right hands. That's gotta be like running into a brick wall right there. Yeah. And then just getting thrown like a rag doll. Coming up next in our tertiary main event as Czar. Good God, man. Just freaking, I don't even have the proper words. Just ruthless. Goes for the pin after that stalling vertical suplex. And Aquile somehow able to kick out the Iranian Hulk. Just tearing in. Aquile now has this half camel clutch locked in. Yeah, come on, man. This is a Christian family show. It's PG. We can't air a murder live. Aquile gives himself a couple of seconds. If I were him, I would have run the hell out of here, but instead, reverse DDT. Stomp to the chest and a kick to the chest. Tries to go for a cannonball senton. Gets up the knees to Czar, and what a clothesline. Woo! Not gonna stop there either. The bear hug. Czar squeezing whatever life Aquile has left. Squeezing and squeezing. Aquile taps, yeah. I didn't think so, Bubba. A dominant win for Czar here tonight. And to the other 29 superstars in the Royal Rumble match, good luck. Look at this, Aquile begging for mercy, saying, hey man, thanks for not killing me. Is it too late to change my pick? It's our tertiary main event coming up next year on Octane episode 30, guys. Still to come in our co-main event, we will see Josh Wolf one-on-one with Anarchy champion Blake Virtue, guys. That's main event of any given pay-per-view worthy. We're getting it here tonight. And then, of course, in our main event, the Unified World Tag Team Champions, the S&S Connection, Slayton Hawks taking on the Ted and Joseph Santos. But first, mixed tag team action as Marvelous Marvin and Melandro Munoz prepare to go up against Gavin Epsilon and Jay Devine. Now, apparently there was a little bit of a scuffle backstage a couple of weeks ago between Marvelous Marvin and Gavin Epsilon. Melandro Munoz and Jay Devine getting involved as well. The two had to be pulled apart. Haven't really gotten any more details other than that leading to this matchup here tonight, though. We know that Marvelous Marvin and Bay have been getting tight since Marvin's return last month. We, of course, know that Gavin Epsilon, a friend of the Devine family. Marvelous Marvin, as well as Gavin Epsilon, a part of the Men's Royal Rumble match. Melandro Munoz and Jay Devine, a part of the Women's Royal Rumble match. I said last night on Shockwave, I'll say it again, momentum always important, but I'd say more than ever at a time like this, with mob violence less than 2 weeks away. The artiste making love to his canvas. Melandro Munoz and her gals might have a considerable advantage many might not think about in the Royal Rumble match. If the three of them can get into the match around the same time, they might be able to work together and get everyone else out. And look, I'm not one to brag, but I don't know if you know this. I did last longest in the Royal Rumble match a couple years ago, so I know what it takes to survive in a matchup like that, you know? Marvelous Marvin and Melandro Munoz, maybe the I'm trying to think of a good enough word to describe the beauty of a team like Marvelous Marvin and Melandro Munoz, but I don't think there's a word that exists, at least not in English. Gavin Epsilon, a man who not so long ago thought his dream of being a CMU superstar was down the drain after he was permanently kicked off of Shockwave, but managed to get himself a deal here on Octane. And he's got a score to settle with Marvelous Marvin tonight. Needs himself a bit of backup, though. And his relationship with the Devine family, well documented since he first debuted here in CMV. Became pretty good friends with Paul Devine during his time on Shockwave. Devine putting in a good word. And so Jade, more than happy to lend a hand here tonight. We did actually see these two team up last month in mixed tag team action. So they got a bit of experience working together. Might give them somewhat of an advantage against Melandra Munoz and Marvelous Marvin here. Jade Devon, already a Hall of Famer, but one of the very few things she has yet to accomplish, winning a Royal Rumble match. Maybe looking to strike that off the bucket list as the fella is going to get things started here. Marvelous Marvin looking to embarrass Gavin Epsilon. Not about to be done dirty like that. Epsilon with a swinging sit out face buster. Quick dragon scoop from Marvin, guys. Mob violence shaping up to be a hell of an event. We, of course, already know the Royal Rumble match makes its return. 30 men, 30 women. Slingshot dropkick from Epsilon. We also know that the undisputable heavyweight championship is going to be on the line as Leon Gotta, winner of the six-pack challenge and attack on Australia, will challenge Chris Diamond. We know that the global championship is gonna be on the line as the agent defends against both the Ted and Joseph Santos, a triple threat match. We know Hunter Quinn will challenge Jeremy Barmore for the Intercontinental Championship, guys. We also now know that Ugbjorn will challenge Blake Virtue for the CMV Anarchy Championship. Just found that out a little earlier tonight. Of course, we're gonna see Blake Virtue in action. Up next in our co-main event as Jade Devon sends Melandra Munoz to the outside. Looking to take the end, but Munoz catching Devon off guard with that spinning back elbow tag to Marvelous Marvin. To the outside. Doesn't seem like Gavin Epsilon interested though in chasing after him, instead showing off the 18-inch python brother to Jade Devon. Jade Devon's taken, man. She and Sam Valentine go way back. Don't get any ideas, Gavin. Up into the fireman's carry position. Elbows to the side of the head. Marvin able to get himself free. And now a hammerlock scoop slam right down onto the CMV logo. Tag to Munoz. Center of the ring. Devon using those lethal kicks. This Marvelous Marvin continues his attack on Epsilon at ringside for no good reason. It really do just be like that sometimes. Munoz, springboard, head scissors, dang. Extends the arm. Marvelous Marvin in the background with a vertical suplex to Gavin Epsilon. Back in the ring from side control. Melandra with some closed fists to the face, and now, oh, drilling Devon into the canvas. One, two, nearly getting the dub for she and Double M. Now goes to Brett's rope, the best moonsault ever, but Devon not interested. Getting up them knees, gives herself an opening here, takes down Munoz. Decides, smart move to make the tag to Epsilon. Kick to the back of the knee. Oh, makes the mistake of turning his back on Marvin and pays for it with that sit-out sidewalk slam. Forearm smash. Blocked by Epsilon. Elevated butterfly DDT. And the artiste might be seeing birdies right now. back into the game with some elbows to the jaw. They're gonna turn the page on Epsilon. Forearm smash, busting Mr. Clean wide open. And then makes the tag to Melandra Munoz. Ooh, and that looks like a really nasty cut as well. Right alongside the left eyebrow of Epsilon. Springboard clothesline has no effect. Scoop slam though, Devine drops down behind. Backstabber! Munoz straight back up though. And fires off! Oh, the rose plant! Hooks the leg, 1, 2! But Gavin Epsilon shouting in Johnson's ear, distracting him long enough for Devine to get back to her feet, kick to the midsection. And Devine looking to roll the dice! Hooks the leg, 1, 2! Munoz looking up the lights right now. Devine has got her hurting for certain, and the cheeky Japanese girl knows it. Brings her into the corner. Knife edge chop, and again. Beautiful disaster kick. Munoz gotta be in La La Land right about now, but still in the fight. Springboard moonsault, quick to hook the legs. Look how she hooks both legs as well. Might have had the match 1-2 if not for Gavin Epsilon again making the save. A half camel clutch applied. Melandra Munoz, I'm sure, ready, willing, and able to take the head off of Jay Devine right now. Shinbreaker dragon screw combination. Devine gonna begin to wear down Munoz. Enziguri taking a lot of nasty shots to the head in this match, but to the top rope, Divine Arrow connects! One! What? Wait, what the hell just happened? Wait a minute, what? Johnson just disqualified Marvelous Marvin! But I don't know why. What happened there? Jade Devine hit the Divine Arrow. She was going for the pin. Marvelous Marvin got into the ring. Did he accidentally kick Devine in the head, maybe? I think that might be what happened. I think he accidentally or maybe intentionally kicked Devine in the head as he was getting into the ring, and Johnson calling for the bell. Damn! Very strict with the rules tonight. Jay Devine and Gavin Epsilon victorious via disqualification. Into our co-main event we go, lads and gents, here on Octane, episode 30. And this is a matchup that can headline any given pay-per-view, but we're getting it right here tonight. Josh Wolf one-on-one with Blake Virtue. And we now know that come mob violence, that man right there behind Josh Wolf, Ugbjorn, will be challenging Blake Virtue for his CMV Anarchy Championship. We also know, guys, another matchup made official earlier tonight. Josh Wolf, one-on-one with Amber Reed, a rematch from a couple of weeks ago. Last episode of Octane, the main event, we actually saw Amber Reed and Josh Wolf work together to knock off the S&S connection, but there was a lot of animosity between the two of them during that match. And Amber Reed even went on Twitter afterwards and said, "I don't really know what Wolf's problem is with me. I tried to, you know, get on the same page with him. In the end, we got the win, but certainly wasn't easy." But indeed, Wolf has targeted Amber Reed. Wants to take her head. We've speculated that maybe it's because Amber Reed is seen as a hero for a great many. Not just in that locker room, but of course in the CMV universe. For all that she's accomplished. And Josh Wolf wants to kill our heroes. A tentative alliance last episode of Octane, but now Wolf getting what he wants, a rematch against Amber Reed. Come mob violence. Tonight, he takes on a good friend of the History Maker. The CMV Anarchy Champion, ready to defend his championship against Ugbjorn at Mob Violence. It was a couple weeks ago after Blake Virtue's win against Amare Rivers that Ugbjorn came out onto the stage and challenged Virtue. Virtue responding the following week after Ugbjorn defeated Amare Rivers one-on-one, coming right down the ramp into the ring, face-to-face with Ugbjorn, held that championship right up in his face and said, "You want some? Come get some then." And Ugbjorn is certainly coming to get him some at Mob Violence. Looks like we are going to have a crowded ringside area for this match. Ugbjorn in the corner of Josh Wolf, Amber Reed in the corner of Blake Virtue. For what is sure to be a humdinger here in our co-main event. Of course, still to come up next in our main event, guys, the Unified World Tag Team Champions, the S&S Connection. Slayton Hawks up against the team of Ted and Joseph Santos. Excuse me, here we go. Wolf Virtue one-on-one. Wolf gonna throw Virtue into the corner to get things started. Clothesline, followed up by a snapmare and a rolling neck snap. Kick to the lower back. Wolf gonna flip Virtue over, and Wolf certainly not wasting any time getting the task here on the Anarchy Champion. Knee to the gut takes Wolf down. Opens him up with that kick to the middle of the back, kick to the chest, though gets caught, turned into a Dragon Screw. Half Camel Clutch. Wolf already looking to do some big time damage to the Best Bout Machine, but a Hangman's Neckbreaker gives Virtue the upper hand again. As Wolf tries to get right back up, Virtue gonna keep him down with some simply nasty looking knees to the side of the head, but again, Josh Wolf right back to his feet. Virtue saying, "Stay the hell down," with that forearm smash. Ugbjorn getting a front row seat seeing what's coming his way at Mob Violence. Biggest matchup of Ugbjorn's short CMV career. He's been around since the start of the new season. He's always been incredibly impressive, but especially over the last month or so. Will he earn his first taste of CMV gold? Running neck breaker and another kick to the middle of the back. Virtue off the ropes, knee to the face, and Wolf already gets busted open. Well, that seems to have woken him up. Drop kick to the chest. A deep cut along the left side of Wolf's head. Straight back up, pop up, Hurricane Rana. And Wolf likes to fool you, man. He's not typically very agile, but sometimes he pulls something like that out of his ass. Punches from side control. And a headbutt. Gonna smear some of his own blood on Virtue's face there. See that? He looked over at Anne Marie for a split second. Stomping on the arm, late Virtue. Looking to trap Wolf with the Collar City Clutch. Collar City Clutch locked in. Ugbjorn watching on there in the background. Looks like he's getting some secondhand pain. But Wolf able to escape. With a couple of well-placed elbows. Virtue waiting for him. Pulls him up into the powerbomb position. Eliminated from the Royal Rumble. But just as he gets rid of Josh Wolf, Ugbjorn gonna make his presence felt from ringside, distracting the Anarchy Champion, and Virtue, I thought for a second he was gonna go say what up to Ugbjorn face to face. Wolf able to utilize that time. Another Hangman's neckbreaker reversed by Wolf. Virtue's got an answer for everything though. Throwing Wolf into the corner. Look at Ugbjorn doing his best to get out of the skin of Blake Virtue here. Back into the ring. Virtue gonna wait for Josh Wolf. Oh, gets a bit impatient though, and Wolf gonna throw him back into the ring. As Wolf now saying what up to Amber Reed. Virtue catching him with that knee to the chest. Vintage hooks the leg. 1, 2, 3. Wow. Close but no cigar for the best bout machine. But we know what comes next. If I'm thinking correctly. No, I thought he was going to look for the recoil, but instead throws Wolf down to the outside again. Virtue giving himself a couple of seconds to think of his next move. Knee drop to the extended arm, up to a count of two. Wolf back to his feet with a jawbreaker. Stunning Virtue just long enough. Able to throw the Anarchy Champion right into the barricade. And Wolf letting out a mighty roar as Virtue gets back into the ring and hits the recoil. Don't take your eyes off Blake Virtue. There's why. Sheesh. Virtue even a bit confused. He thought that was a three count. And these fans chanting, we're not worthy. Like I said, this is a pay-per-view main event worthy matchup here. And it's been popping so far. Virtue with some punches to the right knee of Josh Wolf. Maybe trying to eliminate Wolf's main maneuver, the V2. God, man, he is tearing that knee to shreds. Wolf finally saying enough is enough. Headbutt again. Extends the arm, knee drop. Both Ugbjorn and Amarine watching from ringside as Wolf stomps on the face of Virtue. And man, Wolf loving the headbutts tonight. Still bleeding from that cut. There's a kick to the side of the head Virtue getting himself back into the fight. High kick, knife edge chop, spinning soul kick. Takes Wolf down, leaves him wide open for that kick to the back, and another knee drop. That's what busted Wolf open to begin with. Hooks the leg, one, two. Virtue getting frustrated here. He can't find a way to keep Wolf down. Another knee drop. But perhaps another recoil will do the deed, but Wolf not gonna let it happen. Final flash! Virtue knocked into another dimension. Wolf looking to capitalize, but Virtue somehow with the wherewithal tries the Hangman's neckbreaker. Wolf gonna push him off. Drops out of the scoop slam, reverse DDT, man, what a match! Wolf wasting no time though. Kicks out the knee, Vintage Wolf with the DDT! Wasting no time, hooks the leg, one, two! Now it's Wolf, wondering how did Lake Virtue just kick out of that? But with Virtue still hurting, Wolf again gonna look for the V, two! Virtue busted open now! One, two! But Blake Virtue not sinking under just yet. Wolf taking a second. Now back on the attack. Shoulder breaker. Looks like Wolf may have gotten another cut, guys. This time on his forehead, yes. He is bleeding now. Virtue has done a number on the face of Josh Wolf in this match. Big old clothesline from the Anarchy Champion. Gonna go for the Collar City Clutch again. Collar City Clutch, look at that, Virtue staring at Ungbjorn as he locks in the Collar City Clutch. And Josh Wolf is in real danger here. Look at that, legs kicking, but does not tap. Virtue, Wayne running into his feet. Recoil, numero dos. One, two, three, Blake Virtue. Much to the chagrin of Ugbjorn, picking up the win. What a match in our co-main event. And Ugbjorn now fully realizing exactly what he has to contend with. Come mob violence. When he faces Blake Virtue for the Anarchy Championship. Virtue certainly seeming more than ready. It is main event time here on Octane episode 30, my fine feathered friends. And we are in for some tag team action as the new unified world tag team champions, the S&S Connection. And look at that sight, man. The company decked out in gold. The agent front and center, the global champion, who of course will be defending his championship at Mob Violence against both the Ted and Joseph Santos in a triple threat match. And that is the agent's doing, by the way. Last episode of Octane, he came down to the ring and he challenged Ted and Santos to the triple threat match, saying he wants to prove that Tracy James is dead and gone. The agent is here to stay, and he wants to take out the Ted and Joseph Santos in one fell swoop. Slayton Hawks looking to soften him up for the agent here tonight. But at the end of Attack on Australia, a truly unholy alliance brought to light as Jackson Wright and the company declared war on all of CMV. A line has been drawn in the sand. Sides have already been taken. Joseph Santos, though, the only thing he seems to be concerned with is recapturing the global championship that, of course, was taken from him a couple of weeks ago, courtesy of the agent who cashed in the Rite of Passage championship. And the agent, of course, winning that championship from the Ted back at Bloodsport. The rat in the hat. We saw just how emotional he got after losing the championship. Had a little bit of a meltdown, but that just tells you how much that championship means to Santos. And he said he's going to make sure that the agent's time with the global championship is short-lived. A sentiment echoed by this man returning to action, guys, for the first time since Bloodsport, where he was caught off guard by the man formerly known as Tracy James, his former tag team partner's former best friend, who just absolutely obliterated Ted. But Ted returning last episode of Octane, getting on the mic. You could tell he was a bit emotional. All those things he said to Tracy James over a month ago, obviously striking deep. And the agent admitting that a lot of the things Ted said were true. And that the only person that the agent might hate more than Ted is Tracy James. But Ted has not only vowed, guys, to become global champion at Mob Violence, he has also vowed to bring the fight to the company. He's chosen his side. I don't think there was ever a chance of the Ted aligning with the agent and the company to begin with. Madison Wright still doesn't really seem to be fully preparing for this war that her brother has declared. Doesn't seem to be really taking it 100% seriously, and I think that's a big mistake. Jackson Wright has spent the past week, man, amassing an army. Says he's no longer content with just running Shockwave. All of CMV will belong to him. And his sister will accept it. His father will understand it. He will make them. Numer numerous elbows to the side of Santos's head there, Slate. Looking for an easy peasy win tonight. As we see Agent watching from ringside. Powerbomb into the final flash, knee and a tag to Shay Hoxton. Not the first time that we have seen Joseph Santos and the Ted team up. Ted touching on that last episode of Octane as well. And while they are partners here tonight, Ted saying, Santos, well, I respect you. Come mob violence in that triple threat match. It's every man for himself. And I will take you out to get to the Agent and to get to the global championship. I think deep down, the Ted realizes that he has created a monster. He is the main reason that the Agent is what he is. Oh, Joseph busted open as Hoxton slams his face off that top turnbuckle, trying to isolate him in the corner. Pulled into a Spanish fly, and Santos looking for a quick steal here. One, that's all he's gonna get though. Now that Ted tasked with slaying the monster he has helped to create. Forearm smash. Ted not getting the warmest reception here tonight for his return to the ring. Seems like this might be a company crowd. Hoxton trying to bring Ted into the corner, but not having any of it is the two-time United States champion, a former Unified World Tag Team champion, former Rite of Passage champion, powerbomb Samoan drop combo, shades of Xander Slate there. Now a pile driver. Man, we've just seen too many broken necks as of late. Pile drivers make me cringe. Was the Agent, of course, who at the end of Attack on Australia, at the behest of Jackson Wright, snapped the neck of Ken Donahue without a second thought. Slate allowing that hot tag to be made. Apparently he wants to lay hands on the rat in the hat. Slate gonna carry Santos into the corner, just throwing him out in the middle of the ring. Ain't nothing but garbage. Now a belly to belly, gonna attempt to launch Santos overhead. Stops that, does the former global champion. Whether Madison Wright wants to accept it or not, guys, whether she wants to believe that her brother is really willing to start a war for control of CMV. She had to have seen what happened at the end of Attack on Australia. What Jackson Wright did when he ordered the Agent to so callously snap the neck of Ken Donahue. If that doesn't tell you that Jackson Wright means business, that he is all too serious, I don't know what will. Madison Wright might not want to see it, but well, like Jackson Wright said at Attack in Australia, he has seen the light, and everyone else will soon enough. Hammerlock vertical suplex from the Ted, trying to keep Slate in the corner here. The OG Dirty Heel up in the fireman's carry position. Dropping Ted on that top turnbuckle, and now gonna stomp a mud hole in him. Gotta watch that five count, but of course, Slate doing what Slate does best. The S&S connection largely in control thus far as Slate goes to the top rope and gotta be looking for that Macho Man elbow drop. Tag to Hoxton, gonna let him come in and perhaps go for the pin. Yes, indeed. One, two, what a nice guy, but Santos unfortunately breaking up the pin. Ted back to his feet as Hoxton is focused on Santos, lays him out with a running power slam, but that allows Ted to retake control, pulling Hoxton into a back suplex. One. Now brings Hoxton to his feet. Knife edge chop. Ted said he doesn't care if he has to wage this war against Jackson right in the company all by himself. He will not rest until the company is burned down! Ted Busta! The agent not even looking at the action in the ring. He seems to be looking over at Joseph Santos. Kick to the midsection. The Ted trying to keep Hawks out of the corner, stop him from making the tag. Dragging him over to the ropes. Back body drop though, and Ted eliminated from the Royal Rumble. There's that tag to the OG Dirty Heel as Santos gets back up onto the apron. And Slate going after Santos. Springboard! Whoa! West Coast pop! Ted! Guys, Ted is attacking the agent! The Ted! Going after the global champion! Going after his former best friend! Beating the hell out of the agent! And the agent, of course, can't respond, or else this match will be thrown out. Elevator at ringside. Slate makes him pay. Still fixated on Santos, though. Slate gonna go and check on the agent, make sure he's okay. What are friends for? Axe kick from the Ted. Seems to be a bit distracted here, a bit torn. Slate more than willing to capitalize on that. Up to a count of eight. Vertical suplex. Slate able to wiggle free. Drops down behind. German suplex. Getting into dangerous territory. Slate back into the ring. Of course. Superstars in the CMV have until 20. Ted gonna go after the agent again. Slate's not gonna have it. Numerous punches right to the jaw of the CMV Global Champion, but Slate coming to help out his boy. And dropping Ted face first onto the barricade. Steel steps. Nearly meeting the ribs of the Ted. Man, the Ted has lost it, guys. He has completely abandoned this match. He just wants to lay hands on the agent. Slate again. Stopping that from happening. Stomping on the Ted's hand here. Emotions are high, man, and that is on full display here tonight. The Ted allowing his anger to get the better of him, and it might cost him this match. Slate gonna get back into the ring. But the Ted doesn't care, he just wants the agent. Look at that agent trying to back away. The Ted chasing after DDT. Right hook to the jaw of the OG Dirty Heel and a forearm. Finally, Ted back into the ring. He should just make the tag to Joseph Santos. But look at this, Ted saying, just bring it. Well, the Ted said he'll take on all of the company all by himself. He doesn't give a damn. Psych out DDT there. Hot tag made. Two Hawks tag also made to Joseph Santos. Jumping DDT into the pin. A nice shot of the Ted's ass there. Hang on, go back. Punch to the gut. Hawks are gonna grab Santos by the hair, knowing that the Ted can't do a thing about it. Drop to the outside, though. Oh, come on. It looked like Santos is about to go for the agent. Hawks puts him down with a Superman forearm smash. And a crucifix powerbomb? He's gonna throw him into the audience. Oh, Santos escaping but by the hair of his teeth. Huracanrana. Oh, Santos is going after the agent. He's thinking about it. Hoxton gonna take this opportunity to get back into the ring. Santos throwing the agent down onto the floor. Hox goes for a powerbomb, rolls him up. Not false count anywhere though. Man, I guess the S&S Connection knew what they were doing, bringing the agent out here tonight. Just completely throwing Ted and Santos off their game. Into the steel steps. Knee to the side of the head though. At a count of six. European uppercut. Kick to the knee and a DDT from the Gambler. Tries to kick Santos in the ass. Superman forearm smash of his own. Agent gonna get a couple more shots courtesy of Santos. Thrown into the steel steps. Hoxton back into the ring at the count of 10. Resets the count. Uh-oh. Now Santos almost getting jumped right there. But Slate deciding against it. Doesn't want to risk the disqualification. Quick roll up. Enziguri. Oh my God, man. Santos. It's almost like the agent is a bright light and freaking Santos and Ted are a couple of moths here tonight. They just cannot help themselves. The agent has made their lives a living hell over the past few weeks. Hoxton in the ring just watching. He's seen enough though. Jumping DDT. Hoxton with an elbow to the back of the head. Now gonna tear at the left arm of the rat in the hat. Elbow to the midsection. Santos just completely disregarding Hoxton to go after the agent. And now gonna pay for it. Torture rack power bomb. Agent just looming over Santos. Santos throwing Hoxton back into the ring and then going after the agent, allows the hot tag to be made. Santos just does not care though. Does not care what's going on in this match. I mean, this is just, I can understand how angry Santos and Ted must be, but the agent can't fight back here. Now busting the agent open. Santos finally satisfied. Might be a little bit too late though at this point. Slate gonna walk Santos over to the corner. Tag made to Shea Hoxton. Double Irish whip, double back body drop. Tries to go for a submission, stomps on the quad. Does Santos bleeding even worse now. Spinning soul kick. Santos very wisely making a tag to the Ted here. Yeah. You're laughing. The agent is bleeding and you're laughing. Ripcord, clothesline. Ted follows it up with a knee to the extended arm. Brings Santos right back in. Not much rest there for the former global champion. Springboard, wheelbarrow, bulldog. Only Joseph Santos. Hawks not looking so hot right now as he gets put into the corner. Tag to the Ted. Gonna see a bit of teamwork here. Double shoulder tackle. Hotch just got his soul knocked out of his body. And right into the T-E-D. One, two, but broken up by Slate, even though Santos was right there. Thrown out of the ring now. Hoxton already back to his feet looking for a power bomb. Maybe, but Ted able to counter it. Cheeky jab, kick to the knee though, caught by Hoxton. Gives him the snake eyes in the corner. Slate and Santos continuing to fight at ringside. The power of the OG Dirty Heel on display with the stalling vertical suplex. But in the ring, look, in the ring, a super 21 countered by the 10. Oh, and Hoxton dropped right on his crotch where the sun don't shine. But from the corner, Hoxton with the punt. The punt hooks the leg. One, two. A kick to the side of the head, and Ted kicks out. Hoxton pissed off as he lays out Santos with a pop-up German suplex. Now some knees to the midsection, but Ted breaks it up. Russian legs, he floats over into side control. Ted just saw his life flash before his eyes, man, when Hoxton was setting up the Super 21. Powerbomb countered again, and Ted just gonna go for the pin here. Desperate, but broken up by Slate. Santos tries to run interference. Ted now focused on Slate. That allows Hoxton to gain the upper hand, puts him in the corner, up on top. Well, not looking for the Super 21. But it's, oh! Fisherman's DDT, holy shit! One, two, but Santos breaking it up. Tries to go after Santos. Santos gotta get out of the ring, man. He's gonna get his team disqualified here. Straight jacket, German suplex, serving Hoxton up on a silver platter for another TED, countered by Hawks. Boots in the chest, right into the drift away, swinging neck breaker. Ted scrambling to get to his feet. Hawks is gonna help him. Into the corner, I think Hawks might be looking for the Super 21 again. Ted gets out of the way though. Oh, another TED attempt thwarted by the gambler, turns it into a power slam. One, two, Santos breaks it up. Slate a little too slow. Santos now thrown out of the ring. Slate gonna keep him busy. This is Hoxton's opening here. Ted throwing everything on Hoxton. Oh, Ted Buster! Ted Buster! Hooks the leg! One, two, three, and the 10! Scoring the win! What a tag team matchup! And despite being incredibly distracted throughout the match, both Santos and the 10 spending the majority of this match, I'll say, attacking the agent at ringside, still able to secure the dub. Hoxton countering the TED twice, but couldn't stay out of the way of the Ted Buster. Great momentum for both Santos and the 10 here tonight, heading into the triple threat matchup, Mob Violence, for the global championship. Only one man gonna leave on that night though, with the global championship in their possession. Will it be one of these two men, or will the agent reign supreme?